Let's first look at invariant to rotation. Here's a simple example again. Let's look at this. And now the same corner in this instance is appearing on another image with a rotation. Now in this case, if we were to go through the whole process and computing the details that would actually let us do the ellipse, which basically would have the eigenvalues and stuff like that. Again, we're not doing this directly, but we actually look at the second moments, which allows us to get to similar information. For this point and this point, the eigenvalues should be the same. The size of the ellipse that we're looking at should be the same, but what should not be is, of course, the rotation. So its orientation has changed from this to this, but the eigenvalues remain the same. Since R is only dependent on the eigenvalues of the ellipse, it basically suggests that the corner response function R is invariant to image rotation. So this object can be rotated completely. As long as these values are the same, we should still get the same R function, and with thresholds and stuff, we'll still get the same point. And in fact, that's what would suggest that these two corners of this image will be identified in both the pairs.